Hello, welcome to the happiest place on the internet. My name is Adelaine Morin, and today I'm gonna show you guys how I get that perfect prom makeup look. You have to make sure to give it a like, and also make sure, girl, you need to subscribe. I know what to do. I know all of the tips and tricks, and I hope that this helps you guys, those of you who are going to prom this year. Let's get from this to fabulous. If you guys want, I can do like a playlist of all of my prom videos, and you can like binge watch them all. I forced my boyfriend to be in them all. I think I'm gonna start off with hair, but tip for prom is to maybe put your dress on before you do your hair, depending on how tight your dress is. Mine isn't that tight, so I'm just gonna go with my normal like clothes. So, tip number one. I have my curling iron. I like the big ones because size matters, and I want to get the big waves. Well, I mean, size doesn't really matter. If you have big chunks of hair and you like, okay, I'm getting too into this. I'm done. I don't know where I was going with that. This is second day hair. I don't know. Whenever I do a special event, I like doing second day hair just because I don't have to risk my hair being wet the day of. I'm not able to curl my hair. And plus, girl, I get to put in my dry shampoo and get that volume. Dry shampoo is my life. Okay, so my favorite dry shampoos right now, ready? This is the Tarte one. It's Hair Goals. They're trying to keep up with the kids, ladies and gents. Another one from the drugstore that's also really good is the Dove one. I really like the Dove one. These don't make my hair look like super duper duper white. Like the Tresemme one, literally I would look like frost. Maybe she's born with it, maybe it's dry shampoo. I think my curling iron's all heated up. The way that I like to curl my hair is I like to get a little clip and do it in sections. So I'm gonna start off at the bottom, so I'm just doing it for my ears down and then kind of just clipping the rest on top. Bell makeup tutorial. Check it out. I'm gonna make it a little wider. You'll see my ratchet setup. Curling iron. I like to curl kind of away from my face. So what that means is like if you were a Victoria's Secret angel, your hair would be blowing away from you. So that kind of gives like the whole Victoria's Secret angel kind of look. Put it down. Hold it in my hand for like a sec just so that it cools down in the little spiral shape. And then I let it down. And I don't do all of the curls outward. Ooh, less than half of them I do inward the opposite way just so that all the curls don't kind of clump together. Because I used to do that all the time. All of my curls would just clump into one curl and it looked kind of weird. Your girl's hair has a mind of its own. And then I just do that to the rest of my head. And I don't hold my hair too long in the little curling iron just because my hair would burn off. I hold it for maybe like 10-ish seconds, not as long as Clay took to friggin' watch all the tapes and 13 Reasons Why. I'm obsessed with the show, by the way. Actually, I just started getting into Girl Boss. Tell me, comment down below what your favorite Netflix show is. Because I want to watch them all. In my dress, there's not a lot going on, like in the boobie kind of area, so I feel like it's okay for me to have like a, not an updo, like a downdo. What'd you do, you boo? See? My dress isn't so boobilicious. It's like fergalicious, but boobilicious. That's what I got. One more section. I like to do like three-ish sections. Oh, and by the way, I just put my curl pieces on my back and then I split these in two, and then whenever I'm like done curling, I just throw it in the back, and that's how I kind of organize my hair when I do my little section. I'm gonna cry. Guys, so I was filming something for my APP. I'm not allowed to say and I did a video with my brother for it, and we were talking about 13 Reasons Why because he just finished it and like, ah! I'm just so emotional. It's such a good show. Okay, and I like to do a middle part, so I'm gonna do the ta-da. I'm happy about this hair. One of my favorite hairsprays is this Pantene air spray. Go on one side, kind of cover my face, go on the other side. And then one thing that I do to kind of give it more volume is to go upside down and spray. And this gives you so much more volume. It's like a magic trick. I tell you, magic trick. I learned this trick in my hometown. My fairy godmother teach me this trick. And like, no matter what, your hair is gonna fall out by the end of the night. Like, no matter how much hairspray you put in, you're gonna be sweating, you're gonna be dancing, you're gonna be rubbing up against everyone, and your hair is just not gonna stay, so don't worry about it. Hairstyling with Adelaine Morin. All that I got were these two things from the dollar store. Hair ties and bubby pins. I'm gonna do three twists and this will kind of open up your face so you can focus on the makeup more and you're like, oh. Having three rather than one really adds like dimension to your look and it makes it look a lot harder than it actually is.
So I'm really just rubbing hair, twisting it, adding hair.
It's so easy. It's so much easier than like braiding. And then when I get to the back, I'm just gonna pin it with a bubby pin.
1 hour later.
Guys, I suck at hair, and I feel like I'm kind of proud of this. So it makes me look like I kind of know what I'm doing. I got the oh so terrible hair ties that hurt so much when you take out, but I think it's worth it. It's prom, it's worth it. So I put them on either side of the little twist, and then I started to do what is called the pull through braid, and it's super, super easy. So what you do is you get strand A, and then there's strand B. So I started off with strand A. I put a little ponytail, maybe like 2 inches away from where my other ponytail was, and I made a little donut. I kind of split it in half and made a donut. And then I got strand B and pulled it through the middle of the donut. And I did the same thing. So I got strand B, I put a little ponytail like 2 inches underneath the other one, and then I split it in half, made a donut, and then pulled string A through. And then I kept doing that over and over and over again, and then it created this little guy, which I'm so excited about.
I feel like the thing that helps the most is like pulling it out.
Obviously these are like the bottom parts of my hair, so I'm gonna re-curl them really quick. It is our magical night. I thought it'd be kind of cool to do like top 5 pieces of advice that I would give to high school seniors or even just people in high school in general. Contrary to what all the movies and everything says, high school isn't the best 4 years of your life. Prom isn't the best night of your life. You'll have many, many, many good nights in your life. Prom may be the best one, but not for everyone. I feel like that relieves the pressure a lot. Another tip is to not worry about having a date at prom. Celebrating your 4 years at high school, wouldn't it be way better to spend prom with the people that you spent the most time in high school with rather than a random guy? I don't know. Another tip, the male's brain isn't fully developed until the age of like 25, so you're dating a child. don't be too stressed out about having your first kiss, having your first everything with a boy before high school ends. Like, it doesn't, nobody really cares and it doesn't matter. So if you think you found the right one, that's awesome for you, but if you're just rushing it, it won't feel as special. But you do you, boo. It's your life, you live it. Tip number 4 is to always request the stupidest songs. Slide to the left, slide to the right. The chicken dance, Oppa Gangnam Style. It makes it so much more fun. And then I guess the last tip that I would have is to take lots of pictures. You wanna remember your high school friends, but don't make prom a whole photo shoot.
Pro tip.
Pro tip. Now, hair is complete.
Hair is complete.
Okay, last little spray. Now, my favorite part, makeup time. Let's do this. Obviously, moisturization. You're probably like, Adelaine, you have an oily face. Why are you putting moisturizer on for a prom? It's because basically when you put moisturizer on your face is like, whoa, it's already moisturized. I don't need to produce any more oils. So, moisturization, a key for oily skin. I like this Nivea Men one. I'm pretty sure Nikki Tutorials, Kylie Jenner's use this. It's amazing. Although it looks kind of but Apple Angels are angels. Now this guy can totally double up as your primer, so I'm just gonna completely skip primer because I'm just using that. I asked you guys on Twitter and I was like, okay, would you want like a drugstore tutorial like always, or would you want like a Sephora kind of tutorial? And you guys said, do both. So I'm gonna do both. I'm gonna try and mix it up a little bit. And actually another tip that I have for you guys is what my friends did last year for prom. Went into Sephora, they made an appointment, and basically I think if you spend like $50 or $75 at Sephora, you can get a free makeover. I've been recently really liking this NYX Total Control Drop Foundation. Getting that on my body blender, and then just dabbing that all over my face. So I'm putting that everywhere. I'm putting it on my chins. I'm putting it on my ears, just in case they kind of show in pictures. I don't want it to be uneven. And girl, not gonna lie, this is like a little bit teeny tiny bit darker than my actual skin tone, but I like it. You know, we don't pick the foundation that we are, we pick the foundation that we want to be. So I like to give myself a nice little tan. Now my favorite concealer of all time, Tarte Shape Tape. If they ask you like, what products do you want to use at Sephora, I'd be like, oh my gosh, Tarte Shape Tape. I'm using light medium. I like to do a little bit lighter than my natural skin tone just to kind of lighten and brighten up my face. And I'm just putting it on places like underneath my eyes, underneath my eyebrows, on my forehead, my tip of my nose, my cupid's bow, my chin, where my contour lines are to make it look very sharp, very fleeky, over top of my eyebrows as well. And broody blend away. I bounce and bounce my way to prom. I bounce and bounce my booty blender. I bounce and bounce my boobies in my boobylicious dress. I bounce and bounce. A song, I don't know what it's called, but I like it. Bounce, bounce. Wonderful, darling. Now I feel like my lips are a little bit, you know, crushed and gross looking. I'm putting my favorite lip balm. It's the rose salve balm all over my lips. And I'm doing this at the beginning of the makeup just because I want my lips to be moisturized and stuff like that before I put my final lip product on, which is, it's gonna be at the end. All right, and I just got this recently. It's the Cheek Parade by Benefit. So I'm using my little hula, my favorite bronzer ever, and I'm taking my little NYX brush with it too. And making like a 3E pattern. So 3 on one side of your face and an E on the other side of your face. Can you imagine if Vanessa Hudgens did like a prom makeup tutorial for her prom at High School Musical? I don't think we have a choice. It's a night of all nights and we'll just ride. Dressing to impress the boys. Girl, if they released this song in 2017, everybody would be like, repressing boys, girls wear makeup for themselves. Try to make a joke in 2017 without getting someone offended. It's impossible. Don't even try. That made me so happy. Now I'm taking this little teeny tiny blending brush and using that to contour my nose. Now I have a Filipino nose, so I like to contour on the bottom parts of it just to make it look a little bit more slimmer since it's a little wider at the end. But everyone's nose is different. And also keep in mind, when you're doing your bronzer on your nose, the thicker your bronzer line is, the thicker your nose will look. So I like to try and do a very small, thin line. Make me look like I have a little cute little snatch nose. Cute, cute, cute. Now with the same brush, I'm gonna be taking my blush. This is the new one. It's their California, so I kind of want to use it. It's kind of like a peachy blush tone, and I'm going for that kind of look. So I'm putting that on the apples of my cheeks, just smiling. We need to look like high school teenagers, so I put blush to make me look alive. I'm not a real person. I'm just a computer animation, so perfecto. Highlighter. Okay, so I've learned tons of things about highlighters recently with like pictures and photo shoots, and girl, you're gonna be taking lots of pictures at prom. So I hope that these highlighter tips help you. What I used to do is I used to get my highlighter, literally dig my brush in and put it all over my face. But girl, it looks so bad in pictures. You look so oily, you look so, it doesn't look as good as it does in real life. So I'm gonna show you guys my tips for when I'm taking pictures. So this is the Becca highlighter in Opal. I love this one. I used to have Champagne Pop, but it broke and I ran out and I hit pan. It was just like a mess, so I decided to move on to Opal. I'm just putting it on my cheeks like how I normally would. I like to put a little bit underneath my eyebrows as well. I'm doing the same to the other cheek. And then I put a little, if you're daring and you still want to be glowy, I don't like to sacrifice some of my nose highlight, okay? And then on my cupid's bow, my chin. All right, now this is what saves me during prom. I got this little translucent powder. This is a Laura Mercier powder. Basically get it on a powder brush. Any excess, take off. I'm just gonna be putting it on the center of my face. Now, when you take pictures, you're like, I'm matte. And then when you go like this, you're like, oh yeah, I'm dewy. Dewy? Matt, dewy. Matt, come in here, please. Look, dewy, Matt, dewy.
Ha, 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 so funny.
I'm almost done, okay? Do you like my hair? I know you do.
Nope.
Less translucent powder. Father, Son, Holy Spirit powder. Translucent powder. I guess we can move on to the eyebrows. So recently I've been really liking, this is the Benefit Goof Proof Pencil. A line underneath my eyebrows, a line over top, and then I do the same with the other eyebrow. And then with the other side, it has a little spoolie. Spoolie this-ish up. Now I'm getting my Benefit Gimme Brow and putting that all over the eyebrows. This makes my eyebrows stay in their lane. Now, eyeshadow, this is super simple. All that I'm using is my favorite palette. It's the Too Faced Semi Sweet Chocolate Bar Palette, and it smells, it smells like chocolate and heaven and Zac Efron. Like, it's amazing. The data makes me look weird. So I'm just gonna be taking, obviously, my favorite color, peanut butter, and then taking that on a blending brush, and then all I'm doing is just putting that on the crease of my eye, and then kind of winging it out a little bit, and then some on the other eye. And then taking the same peanut butter color and then put it underneath my eye. I think that just kind of evens out your eyeshadow and makes your eyes look a lot bigger and more smoky, more schmackiness. Perfecto. This is kind of like our transition shade. It transitions from our normal skin tone to the dark brown, which we're about to put on. Now I'm gonna be taking, this is truffled, and I'm gonna be putting that on our lid. Mostly focusing it on the outer part slash middle part. Now, the tricks of tricks. The way, okay, I am so dumb. I thought that they literally got a makeup wipe and made like the perfect like invisible eyeliner, but I tweeted or I Snapchatted and I was like, how does this person do it? Someone says they use a concealer as their eyeliner, and I was like, like this genius. I'm like speaking to geniuses right now. So I'm taking, this is my NYX little pot concealer. I think the pot one's way better than the liquid concealers right here, because these ones just don't budge. They're way more similar to like gel eyeliner. So I'm taking that on a little angled brush, and I'm gonna be using the concealer as the eyeliner. Was I got the little concealer and I just did as though I was doing a normal black eyeliner. Some tips that I have for when you're doing eyeliner is to start by making the line of your eyeliner in the middle of your eye. And then I like to touch it up on the outside, touch it up on the inside, and then I like to fill it in all the way. And I like to make it thinner than I normally would, just because, you know, you can add but you can't take away. You know, you gotta get a makeup wipe involved. Oh, it's a mess. Okay, and then the way that I do my wing is I pretend as though I'm drawing my own eye. So I pretend I'm drawing a line here, and then I kind of continue it like this. Does that make sense? And then I like to connect the top of my eyeliner to the normal line and fill in. Sometimes I'll get like a little makeup wipe and make it pointier at the end. I like a nice sharp wing. And as you may well know, concealer isn't really supposed to be used as eyeliner. So what I'm gonna do to kind of make sure that it stays all night long, or stay all night long, make sure that it doesn't smudge, it doesn't crease or anything, I'm gonna be getting, this is coconut cream in the chocolate bar palette, and I'm just going over top of the concealer with the powder. Putting the powder over top of the concealer just kind of like, it sets it and makes sure that it doesn't move, and I feel like that coconut cream really matches the concealer that I just put on. Now I know this baby will not budge. And to kind of give the eyeliner some personality, some shebang, I'm gonna be taking peanut butter, and this is gonna go on the inner part of our eye eyeliner, and then I'm gonna get truffled, and I'm gonna be putting that on the inner part of our eyeliner. This kind of creates like an ombre eyeliner effect, which I'm like, I'm like drooling over. Ta-da! And to kind of finish off the eye makeup look, I'm going to be taking a little bit of the highlighter that we use and putting it a little teeny tiny bit on the inner corners of my eye, just to kind of give you that like pop, that little wazam. Now that our eyeliner's all set, I think it's time. Eyelashes! I do this in like every tutorial. These are my favorites, the Kiss 11 eyelashes. They're so bomb. I use them every day. Sometimes I just wear eyelashes alone and people think that I have eyelash extensions on. So the way that I put it on is if you get any tweezers that you like to take it off of the packaging. This is my favorite eyelash glue duo. It's the black eyelash glue, and I put that on my hand, and then I grab each eyelash. Hi!
I played rugby in this weather.
And then I kind of dip the band into
the glue.
And I know eyelashes are so intimidating at first, but literally the biggest tip that I can give you is wait for it to get tacky. Don't, right now, I know that so many girls, they just put on their eyelashes and then it like, it slips, it slides, it's so hard to put on. So literally just like wait a hot minute. Just wait a good old Mississippi minute. So much easier to put on your eye. Plus, if you put it on when it's still wet like this, you might get it on your eyelashes, and then when you try to take it off, it like sticks to your eyelashes and you have to pull out some eyelashes and it's like, ugh, it's like the biggest mess ever. So, biggest tip, wait like a minute for your eyelash glue to dry. Not completely dry, but like get tacky, if you know what I'm saying. I put the middle on first, and then I kind of adjust it on the outside. Get it as close to the your real eyelashes as possible. And I adjust it on the inside. See how easy that was? It just stuck because it was so tacky. And same with the other eyelash. Oh, the luck is coming together. Now I'm getting my favorite eyelash curler. You guys know I like the Forever 21 one, just because they have like that little spring thing. Curling them up to the prom god. May there be good music. May nobody spike the punch. May may the teachers not try to talk to me. And let me have enough energy to watch Netflix by the end of the day. Amen. Prom gods. Okay, now I'm gonna be kind of like mixing my real eyelashes with the fake ones. I'm gonna be taking my Tarte. This is their Lights, Camera, Lashes mascara, and it's their like limited edition unicorn one. My favorite from Sephora is this one and the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. Those are like, oh, the best. I'm just gonna be mainly focusing it on the bottom, like, root of my eyelashes. Cause I feel like when you put it on the top, it looks like very clumpy. You can't use your eyelashes as much. Like, I typically reuse my eyelashes like two or three times. And then I'm gonna be putting it on my bottom eyelashes. You know, like when you're really proud of your makeup and you're just like, oh. I just like look at myself all day. It's like my masterpiece. Now to make us look a little bit more Angelina Jolie, I'm gonna be taking the Hoola bronzer that we use and the blending brush that we use, and then just putting it a little bit underneath my lip and above my lip. Cause like if you think about it, people with big lips, their lips go outward, so there's a little shadow underneath, so that gives the illusion of bigger lips. You can be my flica, the mama say to mama. Now I am such a big activist. In my heart and soul, I believe that the best lip color is a good old clear lip balm, and you can so do that for prom. But I know some girls, they love to have their little lip color, so I felt like a nude lip would look super, super, super nice with this makeup look. This is the Too Faced Melted Liquified Long Wear Lipstick, and it's in Melted Nude. And I'm gonna get my nude lip liner by Maybelline and then just kind of line on my lips. And if you ever feel like throughout the day your lip color is like going everywhere, it's not staying on only your lips, lip liner is the key. If you want your lipstick to stay all day long, lip liner is kind of like a border and it keeps your lip color inside the line. Never, ever, ever forget lip liner. Now I'm using my little nude lip gloss. And I like this one because it's not like glossy, like lip gloss, super shiny, because sometimes that can look a little bit weird. Beautiful, darling. And sometimes what I like to do is just boop, boop. And that's how I kind of get like my perfect blush to lip combination color. And I just like to kind of blend it with my beauty blender. We're done. Now taking the one, the only, the beautiful Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. This is the best of the best of the best. Like if there was a makeup hall of fame, it would be in it. Urban Decay Setting Spray is just amazing. I feel like I'm in the jungle. What? I think we're done. Wow. I'm super happy about how this look turned out. We have our invisible eyeliner, which I like to call little Papa Beyonce. We have our eyeshadow that matches our lips and our blush, which I think, oh, makeup gasm right there when everything matches. Anyone who's wondering, it's a 411 Lemons dress, but I got it at this thrift store called Wasteland, so instead of it being like $400, it was literally like, I think it was like 89 or something like that, and I was like, ching! And my shoes, they're from Ego Official. Look how tall they make me. They make me, like, I can almost see Matt's head, like, face to face, like. But I hope you enjoyed my prom 2017 makeup tutorial. If you want to see more, I always do crazy ones. Every single year I did this one with an invisible eyeliner. Last year I did a cut crease, and the year before I did like some sort of bluish eyeshadow look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure to give it a like, and also make sure, girl, you need to subscribe and click the notification bell so you know every single time that I upload. Like, how are you supposed to know when I upload next year's prom makeup tutorial? My tip of the day were the 5 tips that I gave you for people who are in high school. Yeah, I have Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, Facebook, Pinterest, everything. My username is Adelaine Morin for everything. But I'll see you guys tomorrow. Girl, you know I upload on my vlogs every single day and main channel almost every single week. Have a beautiful, magical, wonderful day. Bye! Are you happy? Show them what you got. Yeah. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing. So that's the butt cheek. Nice onesie. Give us a nice strong jawline. Eh?
Do you have it?
No.
Then you're fired.
Get their shoes.
And out.
You little diva. My name is Adelaine Morin, and I'm... Woo! That's a Vogue prom makeup tutorial.
This is when you leave your date because you realize she's crazy. Dance moves like those is why people end up alone.
Did you stab?
No.
Come in! No, I didn't! I just went like
instant replay.
No, I didn't! No, I didn't!